Good afternoon, boys. It's me, Cassian Corral. Welcome back to Snoop Game, as we're gonna show off more Snoop Game mods. I think last episode we did just two mods, and then we had that Georgia tribute. We did public service enrichments. That was the second mod that we did. And then I guess I can't find it. I know we did something else, but I want to start off with the Anon's Breakout. I want to do both mods this episode, because I know in the second Snoop Jam, there's a second part to this, so yeah. The first bit, of course, is in the first Snoop Jam. Let's fucking go. Once upon a Snoop universe, legend says there was a dispute for humans at that park. No one was able to tell that story except for those that were present that day. I shall not delay you any further, but instead, I will show you the journey. Oh, nice. The park and ending 3. How joyous. Hi, Jack. Waking up this morning was already a pain. Not to mention there was this crazy German guy coated with purple paint yelling at me. I don't know if that's a reference to something. Wonder why he was swinging a wooden plank with a shitty adaptation of Napoleon on it. Who knows? Guys seemed crazy when I was stepping out of my apartment, but whatever. What matters is that Fang invited me to this fair thing going on at the park. Hoping nothing unusual happens. There's my hot goth terror girl. GF. God damn it, Anon. Hey, Fang. I hope it didn't make it wait too long. Nah, don't worry. I'm just getting to the food stand. They are selling... Why is Fang giving me that look? Do I have something on my fit? Sorry, excuse me? Turning around, at first I thought I was looking at a mirror. Look, those shitty circus mirrors. Or like the circus mirrors, but the longer I glanced up and down at the guy, he looked exactly like me. What the hell? Oh my god, it's Inko. It is you! Cousin Anon? It's been so long, I haven't seen you since... Well, I don't know, actually. Cousin? Are you sure you didn't get the wrong guy? Oh, nice. Playing the song. How joyous. You sure you didn't get the wrong guy? Anon, how could you forget your cousin? Hair trauma? Seriously, how could you forget? Inko! Oh, hey. A gator girl on a wheelchair wheels up to the guy with sunglasses. Honestly, if it was my cousin, I would at least have better taste in fashion. It's coming from a guy who buys dollar store brands. Your fashion... It's not the best. It's just there. The whole fashion really screams, rob me, please. I mean, rather Jesus. I'm surprised he hasn't been robbed yet in public. If he went through Skin Row, he wouldn't last 5 seconds. Inko, if you said you were going to go somewhere else, at least tell me. I barely even know where we are to begin with. Is this not Volcadero? Is that not where you live? Oh, sorry, Olivia. I got distracted. First, you gotta meet my cousin, Anon. Anon, Olivia. Olivia, Anon. You have a cousin? What's that supposed to mean? Of course I do. Nothing. It's just that you never mentioned him. I thought he was just your long-lost twin or something. Well, that's actually been baby. While he was explaining our lineage, I sort of zoned out for a bit until Fang put a hand on my shoulder. This guy's my cousin? Hope for a guy who I can relate to. Hey, Anon? Really don't know this guy? No? Are you serious? He looks exactly like you. What's that supposed to mean? He looks completely different to me. Different compared to me. Yeah, but without the jacket and sunglasses, you two look the same. I can't believe you were comparing your boyfriend to the stranger we barely met. I hate to admit it, but Bang is sort of right. We do look alike. I wonder if you could be my body double when Trish comes around. If it distracts her, then I won't have to hear what the trigger is yapping constantly. Bang chuckles and glances at the weird duo in me. Besides, if I knew him, I would have mentioned him at least once. Once ever we got together. I don't think that was right grammar, but whatever. True. Then again, I'm sort of surprised there's not a human here. Why? I guess it's the... But I'm from the fair, you dweeb. I haven't seen a single human except you two. Sounds cringe, but I'm curious. What does that stand for? No idea. Oh no. Human male? Oh no. Something about human and dino couples or whatever. Plus I heard they're giving out free shit if you're a human dino couple. Ah, so that's why you brought me along. So, where is it then? Just a few booths ahead. But that's how we formed a family, I think. Sounds like a blow to bowl. So, I'm going to grab some free shit from... really? We're here because of that too. We could walk and gut job, cousin. Yeah, sure. Nico? You read my mind. Even though I was voicing Roman, but whatever. It's Inko. Someone called? Oh, shit! Hunt it fair! Where the hell did he come from? Sorry, dudes. I thought I heard my name. Raptor, Jesus, don't sneak up on us like that, man. After being jump-scared to death, I got my bearings and saw another... human? Oh, God. You don't look right, man. I think it's the shadowing, but you don't look right. My bad, bros. Say you didn't happen to see a blind raptor walking around here with a red stick, right? No, not really. Why? She's my girlfriend. Just when I told her to wait for me around here. No matter, I'll go look around. Good luck on your double date. In this sense, I saw a car drive past in front of us outside the fair and... Oh, nice. How beautiful. Oh shit, my car! Bianca, what did you do? The guy with the red cap sprinted across the fair to the crashed metal heap of a car. Didn't he say his girlfriend was blind? He found his girl. Yep. We should get going. Nate's right. We should get going before the goodies are gone. Alright, let's bounce. Even though we were trying to get to our destination, my so-called cousin got distracted by the utter boost of these cheap knockoff souvenirs and taking pictures with his camera. Ah, there he goes again. Upon arriving there, there was suddenly a line form in front of us. Great. Oh my god, this is just a standard tent! Why is there balloons on strings, too? Doesn't look right. I knew we shouldn't have come here. Sorry, I didn't mean to make so many stops. The souvenirs look cool. Don't worry about it. At least I have to get some free time with my phone. There you go. I pull out my phone and start to do my usual shit post. Ah, great, not this skinny again. Not you, Inko. You're one of the good ones. But what's wrong? Nothing. It's just a skinny who has been posting bait on some underage post again. What do you mean underage post? What board are you in? What is this all about? Also, Anon. Wait, don't tell me. My cousin leaned closer to the Gator girl's phone, inspecting it. That's a questionable username. Probably an alt account. I lowered my face and pocketed my phone. Hopefully she doesn't catch on. I tried to think of something to find a distraction for Livy before she knows. Fang, do you want to get some food? Oh yeah, I haven't gotten anything since we arrived here. How about you and Livy go and some food while me and my cousin wait here for you guys? Yeah, I think that's a great idea. At least I could do is wait here while you guys grab some grub. Fang considers it for a moment and nods. Why not? Let's go, Gator Girl. Oh, nice. The Baryonyx doesn't seem to object and wheels herself away from us with Fang. So, what have you been up to these days, Anon? Well, it's sort of a long story, honestly. Oh, I've been going to an art school named St. Hammond. Isn't that the school where all the artistic people go? Autistic, same thing. Artistics are just more dickish. Yes, sir. Well, if you want to know, I've been studying at Volcano High. Oh, I heard that school is the best track team, right? Yep, I know one of the guys too. Both of us kept talking about our lives and what we've been doing in the past few months. It turns out Inko is spending some quality time with her. You got any dating advice? Wait, you're asking me for advice? Isn't Tarot Girl your partner? I mean, yeah. Fang and her lovey are completely different, you know? But if you really want some good advice, try to talk to her about some things. Like what? Just talk to her and listen. Even if you can't help, at least you're lending an ear to her. We all have flaws, after all, so try to change bad habits. I know I try to, with Fang. Not to mention, we're all fighting our own battles. Thanks, Gus. I've tried to do that. Nailed it. Thank you, Principal Spears. Very cool. Oh my. Don't be just an asshole, man. If you care for someone, or if they care about you, all that matters is that you show appreciation for them. We both flinched to see who spoke. I'll be damned if he's brown. Brown. Well, at least it wasn't like last time. Oh, he is. God damn it, he is brown. Latino dinos, let's go. Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to butt in, but you guys kept talking, and I can't help but see something. The name's Noah? That's a silly name. I gave my bed for interrupting. Don't worry about it. I assume you got yourself a girlfriend too? My sweet dumb boy girlfriend. Here, let me show you. Noah pulls out his phone from his right pocket and zooms in the picture with his giant Triceratops. Oh my. Damn, she thick. Oh my god. I want to see the picture, man. Hand us a look. Brother, please. Holy shit, is she lifting that whole bench with just her arm? Due to budget cut reasons, we cannot display Mimi the lovely the Triceratops. Cheap ass shit. Cheap ass fucking shit. That light blue sign just says off. Did I just hear that? Where the hell did that come from? I'll take his advice to heart, thanks. All problem, Holmes. The three of us chatted up to pass up the time. It's nice talking to guys whose partners are dinosaurs. I guess we're alike in a way. In the end, the line ended up getting shorter and shorter. Finally, letting Noah get his free goodie bag. I wonder what's in them. Well, I'll find out eventually. better get this to my bib. You like her that much, huh? I love my trigger girlfriend, man. Now you can't say that! That is offensive! Nah, man. My girlfriend don't mind. I think. While those two were discussing how appropriate it is to use trigger, endearingly, my mind faintly thought about Trish. It's in a fang. What if Trish instead was... Nah. Although, she might take me in just to get welfare checked or something if we do get kids. Or worse, be her errand boy. The thought sends me to shippers. Terrors for life. Nah, you two take care, man. Brazil is a good country. It's a good country. We both said our goodbyes and finally got our own bags. I still feel
he shouldn't say that.
Trigger.
Stop that cousin!
There was an echoing lot that I was familiar with and fully turning around to see my beautiful GF. Oh god. Just no. These nuggets, Trigger Express. Looks like Spears' dino wife, I guess. Somewhat. Not gay.
Trigger gay, I don't know.
I know, right? That band was so fucking metal. Not to mention the roadie was being the shit out of a crazy fan with comically large brass knuckles. That shit was hilarious. Oh yeah, don't forget Murtus. I was so jealous that he was the only one who didn't get a sandwich and started having a meltdown on stage. His spasm was so funny and metal as fuck. We both gotta go to their next concert. That's on stage diving. Hell yeah. I see you ladies seem to be getting along well. Hell yeah, we're having a good time. Well, guess who got the goodies? I flashed a bag in front of Fang like a bag of nuggets. Fang notices us holding the goodie bags. Ooh, let's grab a seat. I got some lunch for you, hardworking boys. You mean slaves? Hush. Come now. You two seem to have had a lot of fun. I mean, I was skeptical at first, but Fang is pretty cool. You do have pretty good music tastes. You're not so bad yourself, Olivia. For a glimpse, I saw that Olivia actually smelled generally, then smelled back at Indigo. Okay, this background just screams Florida, man. The palm trees, the gazebo, the structure, the plants, other than the grass, it just screams Florida. After finding a table, we sat down... Wait, what? We sat down all? Okay. And Olivia pushed her wheelchair towards the table. Bang looks at me with excitement. Come on, open the goodie bag. We've been waiting for this. Alright. I don't think this can work out between us. Oh my. Why did you use the sprite of the dino holding a phone? Why that sprite? Also, it's crazy that it's in front of his face. I saw another guy with a denim jacket chatting with what looked like an Ankylosaurus. You know, because of me and a human is a bad thing towards the family. It's not you, it's me, but thanks for thanks for the good bag, bye. Is that the dino? Oh yeah, that's definitely the dino. And he has fingerless gloves. Okay. The Ankylosaurus walks away, leaving behind a sad, slumped down, depressed skinny. I kind of feel bad for the guy. It feels like that dino chick used to only get the goods after leaving. Hey, you alright, dude? The guy snapped out of his thoughts.
Oh, sorry. If you need some privacy, I'll go.
I can't believe I'm doing this, but Fuck it. Nazer was a bro to me when I was at my lowest. Had to be an ass bro for this guy. Sure. Nah, man, why didn't you join us? The guy seems surprised as I said that. For a moment he thinks about it, then he nods. Sure, I'll guess. The man sat next to me.
My name is Inko, and this is my cousin, Anon.
Bang. Olivia. You got a name? Tokume? Okay.
You're from the east, then.
Yeah, pretty much, just sightseeing with him.
For a moment, he stops himself, realizing that he is talking about his previous partner.
Yeah, just those things.
By the way, you live locally?
Sort of. I'm actually renting a place around here. But enough about me. What about you guys?
All of us talked a bit about ourselves and what we're doing, making the conversation seem pleasant. God damn it.
Well, yeah, one of my Filipino friends want to fuck out twink dino with glasses.
Of course, it's the Filipino. Real recognizes real.
He doesn't stop yapping about it. He's clearly in his closet. I don't mean to pry, but even the girl I was with wanted those goodie bags.
What's in them?
I forgot about them. No idea, but it's free shit. Can't complain about that.
Fair enough.
But seriously though, we waited long enough. Open the damn bags already, Anon. Without any delay, I opened the bag. It only showed one thing. It's a rock with googly eyes. Below it attached with strings. Are you fucking serious? Ink also opened his, but to my anticipation, it was a shitty kitty makeup kit.
Wow. You know, I don't feel so bad after being used by that dino chick.
I groaned in frustration and the rest soon followed. That was a waste of fucking time. Yeah. This blows. Oh my.
Oh, is it Mia? So this is where the cripple hangs out.
I turned my head to the direction where the voice came from.
Oh, yes.
It's been a long time, man. We haven't seen Mia in so long. Or I haven't seen her in so long.
Oh, Hot Wheel. I didn't know you had more loser friends to deal with.
Who the fuck is this big Barbie looking ass bitch? Barbie looking ass.
For fuck's sake, Mia, would you leave me alone for one day?
Oh, sorry, did I ruin your tea time? Olivia rolls her eyes.
Look, Mia, we're just here to relax. Can't we just... Oh, shut it, skinny. N-word. Hey, fuck you.
Stay out of this. Bitch. That's my good.
Pulled a hand on my shoulder.
Consider this payment for what you did for me.
I don't think it's a good idea, Takumi. You might die.
Nah. I'd win.
Oh my god. Oh god. Why? Takumi grabs a shitty makeup kitty kit and smears it across his face?
Alright, wench. Kakate. Kakate. Koi.
Was that fucking Japanese? Oh my god.
Wait, no! Is this a heat action? Is this a heat action, my guy?
No. I swear, yes, that sound effect is in heat action deployment. Bunch it, whatever. In split second, I saw him lunge at her and beat the crap out of the parasaur bitch to the ground. She tried to fight back with her tailpiece, but the caiman just grabbed the paint barbie's
spiked tail lifting her like it was nothing and threw her way across us. Oh my god. Even the finishing move. Why is Mia holding a fork, dude? I've seen some wrestling videos, but this takes the cake. I'm gonna body slam her. Or he's gonna body slam her. Ouch. All of us were speechless. Like some actual caveman fighting a dinosaur without a spear. Wait, is she holding a fork? Where the hell did she get that? That's what I'm saying. Oh shit, I think she's gonna use it on him. Oh, never mind. He just snatched it and tossed it.
That's not how you hold a fork, princess.
Due to time. Alright, he's a fucking idiot who doesn't know how to describe fighting at all. So instead of explaining, just imagine he is doing loads of heat moves against her. God bless Yakuza. I don't really care about the defective one. And perhaps enjoy the soundtrack. Personally, this bang is great in Yakuza 4. Is this boss? Wait, I don't think this is boss music, right? Because I did play Yakuza 4. Interesting. Honestly, I don't remember if it's boss music or just regular stock music.
Hey, what the fuck are you doing here?
Well, oops, I'm gonna go.
Fuck, am I the only one hearing this guy?
The defeated smushed terror tomato pears are laid on the ground. Ah, hell yeah. Hell yeah. Ow. Ow. Standing up, she realized she couldn't take it anymore. You got lucky. If I ever see you again, you're dead. Okay, bye. She leaves without a single word, just limping away in the distance. Wow, that was... Yeah, I think I might have gone too far, so I might have to get out of here. But for real, thanks for making me feel like a friend. Even though it was just a few minutes. Keep treating people with kindness. You'll all... That's already redundant. Y'all is the word, man. Y apostrophe A-L-L. That is the word to use. Y'all be kind in return. In a split second, he just sprinted off from us and yelled.
Whoa, I will fight for a dream.
That was
fucking awesome. Oh yeah. Maybe he should get out of here, cousin.
Yeah. The man who's made makeup to fight a woman. People who were that told these tales to their young and passed it down through generations. I think. After what just happened, I said goodbye to my cousin, and love you both were heading to the metro station. Didn't know we even had one. You have to explore, man. Gotta explore. Well, Fing and I just did our usual biz. I wonder what happened to the other dudes we met. I guess what matters is Fang being happy in the end.
What the hell did I just make? You know what, never mind. All that matters, I made something.
Yeah, what you did? What did you make?
Shut up, Black. Shut up, David.
Anyways, thank you, Wanda, so mighty much for all you for playing this. Oh my god, my English. I only just wish that you laughed and smiled. That's all that matters for me. And remember, spread the snoot and Wanda. Make something creative.
Oh. Okay.
Never mind. It wasn't long. I think there's a convenience store near here. Oh my god! Not the Popo, dude! Which Yakuza is it? Is it 5? Is it 4? Is it at least Yakuza Kiwami 1? Whoa, I didn't know they had this fancy ass store! Scan Row usually has shady retail places that would scam the hell out of you for off-brand products. Holy moly, they've got everything, even bread in a can! So my code is Squidward, man. They even have the music here, too. From shopping through the aisles, I see that these beverages are expensive as hell. Man, I should have taken some money off of those dinos I beat up. Raptor Jesus, what the fuck is Booba Tea? Twist Snips? Sack Soda? Leo Pedo, got something nice. Let's see. Oh, it's alcohol, but it looks normal. I'm thirsty, so fuck it. I moved to the register to pay for my drink, and with the little money I have, without any delay, I crack it open and chug it like there's no tomorrow. Tastes like rusted metal for some reason. Yeah. Feel dizzy as fuck, man. I'm tipsy already. I guess that I'm lightweight. But Jesus, I can see double. Oh, that shit's strong then, man. I can wobble around. The cashier looks at me, but before they can say anything, my legs move on their own and up into an alleyway. It looks to be where a few shops around here throw away their garbage. Oh my god. Oh my god. This could be something. I think I see another dino wearing what looks to be a wizard hat in front of me. Is there some kind of con happening nearby? Forget it, maybe she could direct me to the bus station. However, instead of just asking normally, I blurt out. Hey, hot bus, wanna get in me? nice. That is up riz. Dr. Nefarious would never do that. My brain feels so smooth. I can't even think of wrinkles at the moment. God, what was in that drink? Her face immediately scrunched up, obviously annoyed. She took a step back and started moving her arms in an elegant manner. The fuck? Dick Tattle Skadoodle, your body is now a noodle. Wham! Okay. Smiling friends moment. Oh boy, did a 360? Did a front flip? I feel like I'm going to vomit. I can't even think straight. Upon getting up slowly, I inspect my surroundings and... Man, that beer really fucked me up good. No wonder it was cheap. How was it spiked? Where the fuck am I? Everyone looks so purple and hazy? Oh, I feel so groggy. And suddenly there's a smudge in my eye. I keep rubbing it, but it isn't getting any clearer. I swear, the smudge is getting bigger as I keep touching it. Until it's taking up almost all of my vision. Oh. You motherfucker! Oh god. Oh, what the fuck? Who are you? I'm the motherfucker you ate, you son of an Easter bastard! I didn't eat jack shit. No, oh wait. I do remember having that mystery meat surprise back in Japan. You can't! You're going to die where you be! The winged cat stopped berating me and started sniffing the area around my feet. Oh, wait a minute. Could it be the French cat on the way here? Was he holding a plank? A plank. We saw that in the last mod, didn't we? Maybe. I feed a lot of cats when I come across them, but I don't really remember all of them. Oh, I don't should say so. What? It's my brother from another mother. Huh? Forget that I shall lead you to the exit of this horrid place. Wait, can you at least explain where I am? Oh, where are my manners? My name is Virgil. Like, no, not everything is a fucking reference. Do I look like a katana weaver with a katana? So, you are in the Dark Realm, named after the appearance of its inhabitants. This is a place of mockery, where originality comes to die. Does this mean I'm not original? I'm sure you're very original. Anyways, this place is made of three circles. We're currently the lowest one, the Circle of Gooning. Those that inhabit this place have no thoughts of ever ambition beyond the flesh and other fluids. We shall leave before we deserve one of these denizens.
Oh? Oh my. Suddenly, something blocks her way.
Blocks her path.
You're just saying that out loud.
Am I interrupting something, ladies?
I think we're both men.
I'm a cat.
Aren't you a...
Shut up.
Me and Virgil look at each other with confusion.
Well, instead of Tokume, it was Tokage, and he was in love with a man.
Oh god. What?
But he is incoherent. We must not anger him.
Why?
I don't know, actually. He claims to be dangerous, but I haven't seen him do anything.
What is that, Burr? What kind of dinosaur is he?
Careful, he's not a dino. He is something far, far worse. Something that only exists here.
Oh, kill people, you know. With hammers.
Oh my god. No way, dude. We got pronouns and... a snoot hell or something. Burr's a very angry furry. And a weird creature ran away from us while pulling out a hammer. I feel a little bad for whoever's going to run into him next. Right, I see your point.
Let's just get out of here, bud. I don't want you to become one of those chaps.
Oh, nice, it's purple. I don't know how long we've been aimlessly walking, but Virgil seems to know where he's going. We were then suddenly stopped by a human with tape on his nose. Why is he blue? Oh no. This is gonna be interesting.
Hello there, fellow traveler. My name is Justin.
Why did he yell that?
Would you like a shark plushie in these trying times?
He pulled out a scruffed and plant ruined plushie. The wool already bursting out. Oh man. No thanks.
Come on now. This shark plushie is made with the finest cloth and wool ever known to dinosaurs and humans. This baby can...
Listen here, shit lips, I ain't interested. Oh no! Shit.
Oh, listen here, you pal. This is my bread and butter. You better get this all...
Oh no. Oh, ooh. Who is this? Is this a shark? Is this a shark? A scaly? All of a sudden, yes it is. A shark shows up out of nowhere and delivers a sucker punch to Justin.
Hey, that ought to teach ya, you scamming sharky. That plushie gave me fell apart.
But Valerie, I would never sell you anything cheaply made.
Are you fucking stupid? Do you take me for a chump?
She presents her torn up plushie tag. With a description which displays made in China.
Fuck you! Wait until Reddit hits about this.
With that, he runs off. It's rare to see a shark lady here. It's rare to see a shark at all. But goddammit, she has potential. I can see the potential right below her neck. Oh well, I should thank her for getting that guy off my back. Oh my god. I'd go to give her a handshake, although if I was still intoxicated, I'd end up playing my hand firmly somewhere where you shouldn't be. Oh shit, I need to back up and apologize.
Wow.
Wow, tits, thanks.
Damn, I'm retarded. Oh, you men are all the same. Hmm.
Damn, you are retarded.
I pick myself up. It's not my first rodeo, but that's nothing like getting punched by a human. What happened? What happened to that shark?
She left me through a portal behind you.
A portal? Does that mean I can get out?
Maybe. I'm not sure where it goes, and I can't count to your safety.
This could be my ticket out here, or I could get even more lost. What do I do? God fucking damn it.
Okay, go away. Go away. We're going through the portal.
I have to take my chances, Virgil.
If you say so. That guy is not too bright.
Oh? Hey, I'm back! Oh my god.
One hell of a tail.
And that's the shark I offended, to put it nicely. I should apologize. Oh my. Hey, you're that shark from earlier, right? He already looks mad just seeing me. Oh, hold on. I just wanted to say I'm sorry. I was something. I don't know. I'm sorry. Suddenly her expression changes.
Ah, you are drunk.
Huh? What?
Like, really drunk. It was obvious.
I won't explain a lot.
You know, you were with some weird old man, right? I think you took your wallet after I clocked you.
Oh. All I did was get a drink from our local place. Looked Eastern or something.
Ha 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 ha. You seriously bought a drink at that ghetto? Listen, I didn't think you'd apologize. Most drunks don't. How about I show you a place that doesn't spike its drinks?
Wait, this is an adventure.
This is an adventure of a new couple, boys. To be continued? Who knows? Maybe. Stay with Virgil.
It would be best to stay here with Virgil. Well, Virgil, you know this place best. How do we get out of here?
Follow.
Oh my god. Oh, there's even the... on the bottom right, the fucking Naomi Chinese dress plushie pillow. Whatever. Is that... And there's a Trish figure there? Wild. We love Evangelion.
Why are there so many dicks? You don't want to know.
God damn it.
Well, that was much shorter than the first mod, but you know what? That's alright. I enjoyed the first mod definitely much more. The second mod is just so wacky that the fact that it goes to the dimension. I don't know why. I just wanted the proper adventure in this world. With Takumi or whatever his name was. But whatever. First mod was epic. Second mod, it exists. I don't know what I'll be playing next, but I will tell you this. I am going to be going to Switzerland in like 2 days. Me and my family. There might be videos of Switzerland, like when I'm actually in Switzerland, or there might not be. Who knows? But I'll try to make some gameplays of Fate and Snoop Game. I'm probably going to have just Snoop Game on Fridays. So I don't have to like do too much because it's already Thursday. And I'm going on Sunday. We have to do a lot of things. Not in the house. Not just in the house. But outside as well. So, I'm ending it up here. Thank you all for watching. Hopefully, I have a fun time in Switzerland. Which I'm thinking I'm going to have. And yeah, y'all have a good day. And peace out. Y'all stay awesome. I'm not the one who's always right.